Our member company of the year is Sandmeyer Steel Company.
Well, it goes back into the early 50s. My grandfather was working with a number of steel mills in western Pennsylvania, and those mills were interested in tonnage business. They weren't interested in small pieces, cut parts, and he had this vision of a company that would provide process cut stainless steel parts to the process industry equipment market. So he came to Philadelphia. He was an entrepreneur, very hard-charging entrepreneurial type of guy, and started out on his own. And here we are almost 70 years later doing essentially the same thing.
Been with the company now for about 33 years, and I have more of the operational and manufacturing side of the business. So whereas John and Ron travel a lot, I'm pretty much here at the office every day doing what we call management by walking around. I'm in the shop in the morning, in the shop in the afternoon, meeting with employees and just kind of keeping an eye on things. There have been higher demands for packaging and marking and some of the manufacturing requirements, and of course we've taken those improvements and utilized them across the company, not just in the export business.
I've been with Sandmeyer for 34 years. Sandmeyer Steel produces custom cut stainless steel and nickel alloy near net shape profiles for customers.
Not many people have the opportunity to work for a company that was started by their great grandfather, that their grandfather's worked at, that their father and uncle has worked at. So it's definitely an honor and a privilege to be able to do that. The good thing about Sandmeyer is it's not just a family business for the Sandmeyers. We have a lot of other employees that have generations of their families working in the company. So it's really an all-around family atmosphere, which is something special.
So while we've been doing this for about 70 years, and essentially we're still starting with a large full-size plate and cutting custom profile shapes from it, what has changed a lot is the technology that's available. 25, 30 years ago, we didn't have the ability to cut using abrasive water jet. We didn't have the ability to cut using laser technology. We didn't stock some of the specialty grades of steel that we currently stock today.
Sandmeyer Steel is currently exported to 55 different countries outside of North America.
We realized very quickly that if we were going to be successful, we weren't going to be able to do it on our own. We needed partners in other geographic areas around the globe.
Well, it happened really through meeting with the World Trade Center of Greater Philadelphia and beginning to explore markets where we might be able to participate. And we started with the hardest market, which was China.
I've been working with Sandmeyer Steel over 12 or 13 years. John Curley and I have been working directly through the majority of that time. I've introduced them to many of the Pennsylvania overseas authorized trade representatives, and we've keep expanding into new markets all the time.
By going into the global markets, it's helped the company and grown us significantly. And I remember 10 years ago when we were getting started and we didn't know where to start, how to begin, and how are we going to do this. So of course we became active with the World Trade Center, and through that participation and some of that help, we've grown the business to be a significant amount. It's a contributor to our bottom line. It's a contributor to the way we do our business.
If you'd have told me in 2007 that I would be the international vice president for Sandmeyer Steel Company, I would not have believed what you were telling me. In fact, I kind of refer to myself as the accidental tourist, having never been further out of the U.S. than Bermuda until I went to China. I have been to every corner of the world, places I thought I would never be, meeting people I thought I would never meet, and to be quite honest, I've seen more outside the U.S. than I have of the U.S. The authorized trade representatives are based in the countries where we want to deal. They've been instrumental in helping us find suitable partners and also coaching and counseling us on the culture of the different countries which we are now participating.
Receiving the award kind of validates what we've done over the last 10 years. It's been very much of an honor.
Well, winning this award, I think, for me, causes us just to reflect. We've gone from virtually no exports to exporting 20% of our product outside of the U.S.